Let me have to be judicious in what I say. Let me start with saying that I am a Democrat. Okay? And part of the reason that this change in leadership has occurred is because we have a 6-3 Democratic majority on the county commission. But it had not seemed over the last year that was the case. So, now that order has been restored, we are collaborating with each other to identify exactly what you said. What is it that we as Democrats, I'll be frank with you, what is it that we as Democrats want to accomplish specifically so that we can look back in a year and say, we did this, we did that, we did this, and the fact of the matter is we have the votes to do it. So we just have to do it. And it is my goal, my top goal, that we do that. I gave a speech last week to the Children's Alliance, and what I said was, everybody talks about they believe in the children, and they want, but we do everything but what we say we're in favor of. Every time we have a chance to spend on children, we find some reason why we can't. But now here's the other side of it. We also haven't said what the full need is. So, is it, do we need $50 million for this? Do we need $100 million? I mean, what's the number? I don't think anyone has figured that out. So that when we make budget decisions, we can say, okay, well, we can't do 50, but we can do 25. And we know that we need to somehow figure out how we get up to 50. But right now, the only conversation is more. We need to say, what is the need? Identify what the true need is first so that we can work toward it. Okay, let me try this. We don't make much. We make 29, something like that. Maybe even less than that. I do it because I live here, and I care about where I live, and I don't want to be sitting home, you know, watching things and saying, oh, we should do this, and I want to be part of the solution. That's what I want to be part of. Yes, it is a burden, no doubt about it. I tell people that it seems like I practice law on the side these days, and I've got to sort of figure that out. But yes, it does take a lot of time, but it's because I have a 14-year-old son, I have an 11-year-old daughter, and I want them both to live in a community that that they can be proud of, that they can accomplish things in. You know, the fact of the matter is that I am raising a young African-American man, and I am not going to leave that to chance. I'm going to try to do something about it. Well, of course, I'm in favor of following the Constitution and mandating that it be followed. You are correct that the North Carolina Constitution does say that, and there are several constitutions across the country that say that. The issue is always, the rub always is in what does that mean? What does it mean to provide a sound education? Because what you think is a sound education, others may not think is a sound education. But I agree with your basic point that you need to teach the history of the students who are in the school system. But we have to be careful from the county commission level about how much we dictate, how far down into the weeds we get with that. We have people who have been elected to make those decisions. Our job is to fund, our job is to consult and to collaborate with them, But it is not our job to dictate what other elected officials do on behalf of the community.
Good job, so. Trevor. Okay.
We should insist that the school board meet some objectives. We need to identify what those are, and we've not had full agreement on what those objectives are, but there ought to be very clear measurements where we can say, look, you said that with $370 million you were going to do X. Right. You've only accomplished 30% of that. So you coming to ask us now for $400 million may not meet a positive reception. Oh. So we've got to say to the school board what it is that we expect, and then we've got to be able to measure whether or not those expectations were met, and they have a part to play in setting those expectations. They have to be realistic. But that's the conversation we need to be having. Yeah, that's a big one. That's probably the biggest one. Because the question asked of us is, should the county fund a supplement of teacher pay so that at least in Mecklenburg County, our teachers are paid at a reasonable rate? And I'm with that. The concern I have is that when you start doing that, the folks in Raleigh are going to say, well, hey, we don't need to worry about them. That's the concern I have. But you're right that, you know, they're still our citizens, they're our teachers, and we're the ones that are affected by this decision. So it's a very difficult question for me. But yes, that's probably one of the key issues we're going to face this year. I'm having a meeting about that when I leave here, and I need to see what does that really mean in terms of the budget impact of having a nurse in the school. There's no doubting that there is a safety issue implicated by not having full nursing staff in each of our schools. There's no doubt about that. The question is, can we do that? Can we truly afford having a nurse in every school? What does that mean? And are there alternatives? But there's no doubt. I mean, my son has it's not quite a peanut allergy, it's a peanut butter allergy, which I don't understand, but he has an allergy. So the fact that there is not a nurse in every school is something that I do think about. Who's going to administer that EpiPen when there's some issue? So, but I just don't know how we can, I don't know what our ability to actually do that is. But we're talking about it. Because we have better ideas. I have no problem.
That's all you need to say.
I think we may say the same thing, but
well, except ours are provably good ideas. Theirs are not. And I have not been shy about talking about this reckless General Assembly. And I think it's reckless because they don't consider, for a group of folks who said that local government is where it is, at where the people are is where they should be governed. But suddenly when it comes to this group, Raleigh knows better. Now, I will tell you that, particularly with respect to the MechLink issue, that I think there are other things going on than good public policy. But I won't speak too much about that.